Now I've got a bio for Ted Fard. Theodore Ted Pharaoh. The magic of caps lock and how you can't tell letters apart sometimes. Born December 24th, 2013. Jesus. So he'd be 4 years old right now. Future is an American entrepreneur and business magnate. He is the founder of Pharaoh Automated Solutions, FAS. The largest corporation of all time, the world's wealthiest individual, and the first ever trillionaire. Born and raised in Salt Lake City, Utah, he enrolled at the University of California, Los Angeles, where he studied business for 2 years before dropping out in 2033 to start FAS. Though it struggled at first, the company broke through at the end of the troubled 2030s with its popular lines of personal servitors and bodyguard bots. Then exploded when its famous line of green robots led the race to solve the climate crisis during the 2040s clawback. At the end of that decade, FAS opened a military defense branch, dominating the world market for automated military platforms by 2053. The success of FAS has made Mr. Pharaoh the world's best-known businessman, one of its most sought-after speakers, and a major voice in politics, culture, and international affairs. So Ted Pharaoh basically changed the world, more or less. He was the guy that actually ran the company and ultimately led to the current state of things. It's also that thing when you hear about, like, the people who are going to change the world are being born right now and stuff like that. Like, the idea, like, next Steve Jobs is 2 years old right now and things like that. And so he must have hired Elizabeth, and she was the brains behind the actual projects, the technology and stuff. But then she, of course, was turned off by the whole militaristic part that came later. History of FAS. Pharaoh Automated Solutions, FAS, is an American multinational corporate entity that produces robots for all walks of life. Though its core business consists of military and defense contracts, as of 2063, FAS has ranked number one among the Fortune 5 by gross revenue and profit for 10 years in a row, a world record. Founded in 2033 by Theodore Ted Pharaoh, an entrepreneur of Salt Lake City, Utah, the company developed several promising robot prototypes in its early years, but failed to break into markets dominated by then-industry giants like General Synthetics and RE Corp, something like that. This changed in 2038 with the debut of the Alfred line of levitating personal servitors, which generated exceptional sales, lifting the company onto the Fortune 50 for the first time. Profits tripled in the 2040s as the company's environmental efforts, led by the famed engineer Elizabeth Sobeck, catapulted FAS to the head of that sector. In 2049, in the wake of a successful green and climate cleanup efforts around the globe, worldwide approval ratings of the FAS exceeded 90%, and founder Ted Pharaoh was hailed across the media and social networks as the man who saved the world. Yet it was the emergence of FAS as a military contractor in the late 2040s that cemented its status as the world's wealthiest corporation. With a record market capitalization of over $23 trillion, by 2055, FAS controlled 61% of the market share for automated military platforms, holding contracts with 353 nations, transgovernmental organizations, and corporate entities. Today, its holdings exceed the second largest corporation, FB Mobile Global, by 321%. So they were a mega, 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 mega corporation that ran everything. Definition: corporation. An association of individuals created under authority of law, having existence, powers, and liabilities distinct to those of its members. In a business sense, a corporation is usually owned by shareholders, though the sale or distribution of stock through the sale or distribution of stock, whose profit from such ownership vote at designated times for its governance and designate executives who run its affairs. Most corporations engage in one or more industries to produce goods or offer services for profit, and may in turn own other corporations, companies, and property as holdings. This entire concept is so foreign to Aloy that she needs to have the definition if they're even being a corporation in the first place, like, explain to her, because, like, what the heck is even going on here, and what does it mean? Ooh! I almost have a complete vessel set. I might actually want to hunt down the last one to see what the reward is then. If I can figure out which one it is. Let's see. They're not really listed by region is the issue. I might be able to figure it out based on that though. Huh.
It was a corporation. A group of people, not unlike a tribe. And they made machines.
Yeah, go on.
I've uploaded some data files to your focus. They'll help you understand.
Heh. I read the documents first because I just saw the pop-up and didn't even have the context for why the pop-up happened. I was like, why do I have these files all of a sudden? I don't know, I'm gonna read them. It's important. I do wonder how much of that stuff Aloy, of all people, will understand just because of the lack of cultural context. Like, it's an explanation that makes sense to us, but her world is so different from anything that happened there that, like, could she even contextualize half the stuff being said?
Now, I know this must seem like a bizarre change in direction. I mean, we're Pharaoh Automated Solutions, right? Number one robotics firm in the world. Why would we clear our production slate to fabricate human-operated vehicles and weapon systems, the relics of the past? All I can say at this juncture is... trust me. We will be exploiting a massive, growth opportunity by retooling and reallocating capacity according to my plan. So I will need revised projections of mass fabrication velocity across every pipeline within 36 hours.
So they were making machines, but then they stopped to make other kinds of weapons? Why?
Is it because Sobek left? Or is it because he had ulterior motives? Was this the beginning of the attack? This was the beginning of when everything went wrong and society collapsed? Were they planning a war? Were aliens invading and they just didn't want to say about anything about it yet? So like, listen, we need a lot of weapons, like, fast. Because there's incoming alien invasion in like a year and we gotta get prepped. That'd be a really weird turn for this to take. Or maybe he goes full Cave Johnson and just loses his mind and just starts doing completely insane things. I don't want your lemons. What am I supposed to do with these? More stuff for free.
The air. There's no smell to it. Not even old death. Nothing natural.
It's all recycled air. Although, the idea of it being pure recycled air... Whoa, that's actually a passageway. The idea of it all being recycled and pure air feels a little weird because there's clearly a leak somewhere. Was there a place to go around here? Yeah, there is. Which way should I go? Is this a dead end?
Another cave-in. But I could get through.
Oh, is there a spot I can squeeze through? Ah. So I have multiple paths I can try. Response to a complaint from Dre Friedkin to a receptionist. Hey receptionist, if that is your real name, want to know who scheduled Indo-Malay right next to Fresh Grounds? That would be me, Senior VP of Sales. Want to know why? After the little hair-pulling incident, both sides increased their bids by 40%. I'll explain. Because your receptionist-level brain probably requires it, those two sides are fighting. And what do we sell? That's right, combat machines. We want them to hate each other, so they will try to fight each other with what? That's right, again, combat machines. Which they will pay us a lot of money for. So I suggest you go back to serving coffee with a blank smile and letting me do my much more complicated job. Thanks, Mr. Friedkin. To you. So he's a terrible human being, is basically what's going on here. Yay! Yay! Because he's like, fuck you and your way, fuck you and your life, stupid receptionist lady that isn't capable of high-level thought. But also, yeah, we're pitting people against each other for our own benefit in the form of war! Yay! I'm the morally righteous one here. No. No. Okay, this clearly connects to the rest of the facility. So I'm gonna check out that weird mini cave I found. Because this place clearly is like the rest of the level. Whereas this was like a secret. Not there. Here? Yeah. What does it even look like on the map over here? It doesn't even have a map for this part of the map. Like, it becomes the world map instead. Well, then you're definitely gonna have a secret in here. Secret, secret. Everything's red and weird in here. Supplies. Nothing stands out though, just kind of the usual. Can I press the button? Nope. Oh. Is that all? Am I supposed to find another secret in here to continue? This light coming out of here almost makes me think that I can move the bookcase or something. Like, because that's usually when those light coming out from behind something, that usually means you can go through it in real world stuff. But in video games, that just means that the light collision's doing weird stuff. Aw, that might be all that's in here. Well, it was worth a look. Now if you excuse me, I'm gonna go back to unraveling the fabric of our modern society and how the world works in ways that no one will ever believe when I try to tell them. I have almost no one to confer to besides the guy from Fringe that's talking to me in my ear. That's the perfect voice to choose when my entire world... when my entire world's about to become unraveled. Wow! Good thing I didn't take one more step before backtracking to check that out, or I would have been frustrated, huh? Or does this go right back up?
Looks like I can climb here.
Nope, that's not connected.
Use that as a ramp to get back up.
There was a hole there in the platform in front of the... Okay. The ladder led directly to a hole. Am I... Receptionist log. Oh yeah. So I am in the front chamber again now. That wasn't very nice. Was I supposed to bring that thing down somehow so I could climb? And now I'm just stuck. Oh, is that what fell? Okay, so when things collapsed, it became a shortcut. Okay, and climbing is the way I continue. Okay. That's good news. That's very good news. Because I immediately fell in a hole. Where was it? Oh, it's right there. It's the only hole. That's mean. Can I do something with you? This track? No. Alright. This is one way to shortcut back to the beginning, I suppose. Nothing to climb on here. The door doesn't open. It's a dead end with a chest. Can I pull this? No. Do I jump across somewhere? Like, ha? Where's my goal? So it's over there. Like, in this direction? What? So that way. That's the front entrance, right? I think that was the front entrance direction. Maybe it's open now? Was this hole here before? This doesn't seem entirely familiar, I suppose. We're definitely running into a little bit of that issue of, like, this place all looks the same. Just a lot of it does. Which can run cause some problems when I'm trying to figure out how to proceed. His office is right there. It's, like, on a different floor, though, right? He's on the top floor. So he's on floor 12. I'm on floor 1. I believe that's the front entrance over there. Let's see, I think that's the front entrance. There's a staircase right here? Can I climb this? It looks so climbable. Oh, ladder. Now have I been... Okay, is that how I got... That's where I got in, isn't it? Okay. Right. This is how I got in the first place. So I was right, it was the front entrance. Alright. So now I have a better idea of what my goal was. I was wandering blindly without the map, because that's just how I've done all of these locations so far. But now I have a more specific goal, which is I'm trying to get to floor 12. Man, that map sometimes can take a long time to load. Let's see here. So I'll try climbing this again. See if there's just any way to go up to the next floor. Oh. Okay. Look for yellow then. We need to mirror's edge this. There we go.
Made it.
Welcome to floor number 3. Weird. You can count this as 25% progress through the tower.
It looks like the way up. What's left of it.
There was another ladder there. Hi, you're a cool looking room. Holo projectors. Yes, I will.
The ACA-3 Scarab combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package. Designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance, it boasts the world's highest survivability rating of any Scout-class autonomous agent. Maybe it's the Scarab's emergency biomass conversion systems that ensure it always makes it back to base, even if fuel supply lines have been interdicted. Or maybe it's the Scarab's ability to slave enemy robots to its own network. Now that's force multiplication. Add a prehensile manipulator arm that can handle a host of functions. From 360-degree less lethal riot management to surgical repairs of allied chariot line models, and you've got the workhorse of any cutting-edge peacekeeping fleet.
The Corruptor. Slave enemy robots to its own network. It sounds like it's talking about how it corrupts machines.
It had repair abilities and non-lethal takedowns for enemy combatants. The Scarab.
The BOR-7 Horus. Imagine your complete engagement ecosystem comprehensively managed by a high-speed learning machine network. Whether your need is to replace battlefield losses or intensify force projection, the Horus's onboard manufacturing capabilities mean you'll never get stuck waiting for the next arms delivery. Simply redefine your force parameters, and the Horus will fabricate additional units to fill the ranks for an affordable per-unit licensing fee. Meanwhile, the biomass conversion systems of other chariot line models allow them to keep the Horus fueled, repaired, and ready, extending its operational tolerances beyond that of any competing Titan-class platform. That's the Horus advantage. Always regulating, always ready. The future of automated warfare made real today.
The Metal Devil. So these were Faro machines too. Manufacturing capabilities. They can make more of them.
The FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction delivers unmatched recoil dampening, allowing you to field any weapon package that conforms to your budget needs and conflict resolution profile. Patented biomass conversion systems allow extended emergency operations with minimal environmental impact. Multilinear target processing provides simultaneous real-time threat analysis and legal review for autonomous domestic operations. Or control can be slaved to the swarm's neural network for weapons-free force application. Either way, when it's time to call out the big guns, it's time to call Kopesh.
The Deathbringer. So this was the heavy hitter. Main battle force indeed.
The They did a great job then, one way or another.
See, is that just these guys? Integrated waveforms, right. Oh, those count as holograms? That's a bummer. Yeah, I guess they do. So these two, I was hoping they'd be a bunch of, like, human performances, but only two of them have been so far, and the other ones are all these guys. Just a thing that floats in front of you like a diagram. Alright. That's fine. So they did a damn good job creating self-replicating stuff that could last forever, considering that it's definitely withstood the test of time better than possibly humanity itself on some level. It's willing to just continue forever indefinitely. I keep thinking there's gonna be a character somewhere that controls all of this behind the scenes. Like somebody who has somehow taken control of it recently, because they're talking about more recent changes that have been not good news. So we'll see if we get any more context. This is crazy though. And she's so receptive to all this new information, but no one's going to listen to her if she decides to repeat any of this to anybody. The Spiritual Summit. From Ted Farrow to Paula Vassara. Paula, recent events have sharpened my perspective, and I think that I, and FAS in general, have been neglecting the spiritual side of things. Not under any specific religious framework, of course, but in a more general sense, as in not giving enough thought to our shared values, hopes, and aspirations for the afterlife. I'd like you to reach out to religious leaders of every stripe, with the intention of scheduling a conference soon. Very soon. I'll have more thoughts about the agenda later, but for now, let's put out some feelers and see if we can lock something in. Make it a big tent, no kooks. But, anyone with credible audience, let's go deluxe. Make it clear we'll spare no expense. Ah, I wonder what's going on there. I wonder what's going on there. Okay. That seems super suspicious. It seems like a Deus Ex Human Revolution situation a bit. Like it seems like you might be trying to gather people together, not because you actually want to talk to them, but because you want them all in one place for other obvious reasons. And I wouldn't really trust this. I mean, somebody who fills the world with death robots, you just kind of assume probably went off the edge somewhere in the story. What if he's still alive? What if he's alive all these years later as like an AI construct or something that's being preserved somewhere and still running things? FAS campus log. High priority alert. All non-essential systems have entered hibernations. Full lockdown has been initiated. Due to the increasing frequency of violent protests targeting the campus, the security of FAS employees can no longer be guaranteed. Therefore, we have taken the difficult decision to shutter this facility indefinitely. Staff will be briefed on a block-by-block basis regarding proper procedure for archiving and/or disposal of project-related data and materials. HiSec and Crisis Team will conduct exit review for all areas before all areas are locked down. Priority messaging to all staff in E and F blocks. Treat the current lockdown situation as an exercise, but do not attempt to release the hatches or otherwise exit the buildings. A reminder that while HiSec personnel remain secure, while HiSec personnel remains committed to employee safety during the current unfortunate events, personal firearms must be relinquished when presenting for identiscan. Additional public access roads en route to campus have now been closed to relieve some waiting time at the outer security cordons. HiSec reminds all staff that the campus remains off limits to the public. Following recent campus security issues, all staff are reminded that presenting for identiscan and displaying your security badge prominently at all times for image analytics are both mandatory. In light of recent acts of terrorism directed at the rapid transit system, HiSec now offers a Big Brother initiative to accompany staff traveling from off-site. Sign-up is required and strongly encouraged. 48 more entries of high priority, additional entries corrupted. So they're shutting down the campus, they're having protests and terrorist attacks, and everything's going to shit because of what they did.
Which part was it? Is it the part where the
people were angry at Faro, at the corporation? They blamed this place for something. Something bad.
The question is whether or not it's something we know about or something we don't know about. Were they mad about the weapons? Were they mad about pitting people against each other to sell weapons and facilitating more war in the world? Were they mad about the machines themselves that they were being created? Were they mad about whatever was ending the world? Was that already happening? There's a number of little things along the way that could have been causing this. Little things is not the accurate thing to call these. Ooh. We skipping some floors? I mean, I kind of figured we wouldn't explore 12 floors.
Gonna be a long way up. Frozen metal most of the way.
No, we're on floor 4. Okay. No, it just becomes platforming for a while, I think. Whoa, for most of it, actually. Alright.
Making this easy, Dr. Sobek.
It's funny thinking that this place isn't that locked down, huh? Like, that's just exposed to the outside world. You can see nature and bombed-out buildings. So this amazing revelation I'm going to have that I only could find via that door that was locked. I could have just snuck through these roots that are gargantuan and spaced out, and it wouldn't be that hard. And it's not an unprecedented thing either, because in the past I couldn't...
If plants can find a way to hang on up here, guess I can too.
In the past, I couldn't get into one of those vaults, the cauldrons, and I had to find an alternate entrance, and so I did. So it was already been established as precedent that I would do that. I'm sorry, is that two different paths? Ow. She didn't grab onto the thing. Which way should I be going? Because this still goes somewhere. I want to find the secrets, but I don't know which place is a dead end. Ow. This goes way higher. Yep, floor 7.
This began when they engaged in unauthorized offensive operations against robots and human personnel of the Hearts Timor Energy Combine. Now, I wish that I could relate that the crisis has been exaggerated, but it's not. The peacekeepers have not responded to stand down codes, and by all signs, they appear to be replicating at a precipitous rate. Now, what I can promise you, can absolutely assure you, is that I am already devoting every possible resource towards reaching a speedy conclusion to this issue. So when you hear the bad talk about us, against this company, in the days, maybe weeks to come, just bear in mind that we will get past this. That a day's coming when none of this will matter.
Peacekeepers. That's what they called their machines. They were built for war, not peace.
Well, so he made machines, called them peacekeepers, and they lost control of them, apparently. Yep, we're definitely exposed to the outside world now. So they lost control of them, they started self-replicating, started doing their own thing, and the company couldn't stop them. What I'm wondering is whether or not Pharaoh wanted that to happen.
Being soaked from melted snow.
It wouldn't be crazy to think that maybe Pharaoh intended the whole thing. Damn it, that's heading forward. So I guess the other way I should have checked out then. Sorry, I'm trying to be thorough about exploring these areas. But it's hard to tell which branching path should be investigated first. Can you just drop for a little while down here? Yep. Is this the previous window? Yeah. What's down here? Oh, nothing. There's nothing down here! I've accomplished nothing! Haha! Alright, well, that's what I get. They gave me this like alternate looking place to check out, so I'm like, let's take a look at there. But it was just an alternate path to the same location, it looks like. Whoa. I thought I completely missed and was about to have some real pain. Well, this route seems a bit faster than going all the way up the elevator shaft like last time. I keep waiting for some revelation that Pharaoh was some kind of lunatic that had some kind of master plan that led to the end of the world, but maybe that was what he was hoping for on some level. No idea if that's the case or not. Man, she's really good at gripping these icy ledges. There we go. It's like a Where's Waldo game of find the next yellow. Which is the factory equivalent of the bird shit ledges. I think that is another point of no return to shepherd me, probably. Hoo boy. We can go that way. That's the next way up, probably. What? Why is there an explosive bomb trap of exactly the type that I try to usually make in this ancient factory place? That's weird. A lot of the other stuff makes sense because they're the pieces that they use on the machines, and the machines presumably haven't been evolving, but just self-replicating indefinitely on the same schematic. So they would use the same parts back then that we do now. It's not like we're going to change them. Humans aren't interacting with the system anymore, aside from getting killed by it. Just gotta trust the jumps and hope they work out.